And see, and this is where the people of God, this is where Isaac was in a dry place and he was in a famine, but this wasn't a familiar place to him. Because the Bible tells me that Isaac, he listened to his father. Because even when he was a child, his daddy was in a dry place. His father was in a familiar place. What am I saying, parents? Stop trying to hide from your kids that you're going through. Because it's going to be some times that they're going to go through. And you got to show them the posture, what they see you do. So I remember when my mama went through, I remember seeing my mama get on her knees. And I remember seeing my mama praying. So if your children don't never see you getting down on your knees praying to God, you ain't showing them what to do when trouble comes.
All right.
And see, it showed here, this is what Isaac had to do. So when you look at Genesis 26, let's start at verse 1. I'm going to read it in the New Living Translation. It say, a severe famine, I want you to underline famine, was now struck the land as happened before in Abraham's time. See, the Bible's telling you that it happened to Abraham. So Isaac moved to Gerar. See, Gerar is a place to dwell. And it says here, where Amalek, king of the Philistines, live. The Lord appeared to Isaac. Then even I want to stop right there. When I looked at it, say the Lord. When you look at the word Lord, and I looked up that word in the Hebrew, the word Lord means Jehovah. That means that Isaac was in covenant with God. He did not know God personally, but he knew that that was his father's God. Come on here. It says the Lord appeared to Isaac. So the Lord began to show Isaac that I am the all self-sufficient one. Why is this important? Because you're going to understand when you're going through a problem and you're going through a situation, can't nobody help you but the all sufficient one. And so you got to begin to know who to call upon. See, it don't do no good if I need something to eat, Mr. White, and I'm up here calling Jehovah Rapha. See, that's the Lord that heals me. See, I need some food. I don't need no healing. It don't do no good for me to say, you know what? I need Jehovah. Jireh, but I feel like I'm about to have a nervous breakdown. No, I need Jehovah Shalom. That's the Prince of Peace. That's the God who can bring me peace in all situations. And see, he's beginning to let him know I'm the all-sufficient one. What does that mean for you? That I'm the one that got everything that you need. You don't have to call the doctor because I'm the one that will heal you. You don't have to say I need to go to the loan person because I am the one that will loan. You guys say I need to go to the one who can heal me. He said, because I'm the one that be your healer. I'm lonely. I need somebody to talk to. He said, I'm the one that can be your friend and the very present help. He said, whatever you need, I am the sufficient one. And see, the thing about this is he was establishing covenant. What is covenant? Covenant is a marriage. It's where you have aligned yourself to say, I'm going to be married to God in his ways. I'm going to be married to his thinking, to his laws, to his commandments, to whatever that he has for me, because I know when I'm in covenant with him, he's obligated to come and see about me. See, this is very important, because when you look at the text right here, see, that's why the Bible showed us that there was a famine, meaning there was a dry place, right? So it says, the Lord appeared to Isaac and said, do not go down to Egypt, but do as I tell you. See, there's a problem when we're going through, we don't want to pray. When we go through, we don't want to get in a quiet place, not understanding that God is telling him, even though you want a dry place, even though you don't have that much money, even though you don't have that much food, but I want you to listen to me. I'm going to give you strategy, I'm going to give you covenant, and I'm going to show you that I am with you. So don't go over there to Egypt. See, because when you looked at Egypt is the place where they had all the resources. Come on now. You trying to go to the loan office, you trying to go to the pay loan place, and God saying, no. He's trying to tell you not to go, and you saying, but this bill got to be paid. And God said, don't go down that road. I'm not trying to put you in bondage. I'm trying to set you free. But you got to understand Amen. See, God wants you to deal with, you know how when we're going through some stuff and we don't like feeling not having enough. We don't like feeling, my life's cut off. I just can't live like this. We don't like that. You know what? It's uncomfortable for me. It's in a place where I just don't feel right. I ain't got no groceries in my refrigerator. See, God says, see, that's the place right there where I'm trying to get you to submit to me. He said, because when you get up and you stop trying to handle it and let me handle it. Yeah. Come on. See, it's uncomfortable because he trying to show you, I want you to depend on me and not yourself. Yeah. See, we don't got to the point that we don't like feeling this way, and so we don't like feeling this way. I'm going to go somewhere so I can stop feeling this way. And God's saying, I got you feeling this way because I want you to realize that you need me. And see, and when you look at this, he began to let Isaac know, don't go to that place. Because here, when it said here, when I looked at it in verse 3, he says, stay in this land. Stay in this land for a while. And see, one Bible text in the New King James Version, it says, dwell in this land. When I looked up that word, dwell, we'll think that word means stay there. God said that the word dwell, it means grow. It means to stay there temporarily. He said, I want you to stay in this place temporarily where you are uncomfortable. Y'all don't hear me? I want you to stay in this place where you are uneasy, where you're not familiar with what's going on, when you're not familiar with how it feels.